If Maria Gambrelli is not a murderer, and I say she is not, you are sending an innocent girl to the guillotine. Excuse me, Francois. And another thing!
Peter Sellers was one of the most successful comic actors of the 20th century. He appeared in 60 films in a dazzling variety of guises. He was called the human chameleon, the man of 100 faces. He claimed to have no identity of his own outside the characters he played. Yet the real Peter Sellers did appear on film, his own film. He obsessively recorded his life on his own cameras. These films feature his friends, himself, his family, or anything that took his fancy. He always used the latest professional equipment, yet he hardly ever showed the end results to anyone.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Following my dramatic success at the Workmen's Institute Penge, I'm presenting this afternoon in al fresco for the very first time a few very, very successful and highly dramatic quick changes. First will be done, if I may say so, in the amazingly short time of 11 seconds flat. And here's, I think, I can claim quite safely to be the only one in Europe performing these amazing feats before your very eyes, without extra paraphernalia whatsoever. No trickery, no, nothing at all. Now I present, ladies and gentlemen, my impersonation in 11 seconds flat, before your very eyes, of Her Royal Highness, Princess Margaret!
Watching you perform, and indeed watching you tonight and the sort of whole scope of what you've done, I wonder how you would have found this kind of fulfillment that you just talked about professionally. Had you been of another era when films weren't invented, in fact? I mean, what might you have been then? Would you have been the comic actor? Would you have been the classical actor? Would you have been the vaudevillian or what?
Well, I don't know, you know. I always think back to what my old man said about being a road sweeper. I'm a good photographer. I could probably earn my living as a photographer.
Yeah.
I actually, you know, I'm turned pro now. You know, I can, you know, I do quite a lot of jobs as a photographer.
Yeah.
But, honestly, Mike, I don't really know what I'd have done. Because my mother forced me to go forward, you know. I'd have probably ended up as a road sweeper. Doing impressions of George Formby or something.
Good evening. The Antique and Curio Shop. We have with us this evening Mrs. Agnes Sellers, the well-known antique dealer and candle maker. And she's going to give us her opinions of several pieces of antique Georgian silver, which had been obtained for Mr. Peter Sellers by Mr. David Mappin. Mrs. Sellers, could you give us your judgment on these pair of very exquisite candlesticks? Would you say they are early, would you say they are first, second, or third George?
I should say they were second. I should think about the 17th century.
Mm. Well, I'll tell you, in fact, they are George the First.
In perfect condition.
And now this coffee pot. Careful not to spill it, because there may be some Georgian coffee still in it. You never know.
Peter Sellers' mother, Peg, started life in the theatre. So did he. He was born into a music hall family called the Rays.
I used to travel around with my mother and father, and all over the country when I was a kid. See, my mum very much wanted me to go into the theatre and continue, because my grandma was in the theatre as well, right. You see. Mm. The whole family were.
Right.
What kind of an act did they do, Peter? What did Mum do?
You know, Mum used to stand there in white tights thing. It was a real daring thing then, you see. And they used to project slides onto Mum, and she would depict, you know, various famous characters.